Hello friends, myself Praveen Gore, lecturer science department. So in previous lectures I have discussed the properties of solids and I'm done with it. In this video I'll start with properties of liquids. So to start with, I'll be dealing with what is thrust, then pressure, then I'll be finding out the expression for pressure inside a liquid, then we'll be going with cohesive force and adhesive forces, then we have surface tension. We'll see what are the factors affecting surface tension, and then we'll go for applications of surface tension. So what do you mean by thrust? Okay, all the liquids, they have particular thrust, some amount of thrust. So what is thrust? The total force exerted by the molecules of liquid on walls of the container is called thrust. The total force exerted by molecules of the liquid. And where that thrust is applied, where that force is applied, it is applied on the walls of the container. Suppose we have 1 liter water inside a glass beaker. So what is thrust? The total force exerted by all the molecules. So let's see here. Okay, we have liquid here in this case. This is a container, we have liquid. So if I want to see what is the thrust on this surface, then I have to find what is the force exerted by this particle, the force exerted by this particle on this wall, the force exerted by this particle on this wall, the force exerted by all the particles on this particular wall, which will give me what is thrust. Now what is pressure? It is defined as the thrust acting per unit area is called as pressure of a liquid. Pressure is what? Thrust divided by area, which is nothing but F divided by A. So I'll take the example, same example here. I have some thrust here, and what is the area of the surface? Suppose area is A. So thrust is nothing but force. So force divided by area is pressure of a liquid. What it is? Force divided by area. This is what we have done here, and we know what is the SI unit of force. It is Newton, and SI unit of area is meter square. So SI unit of pressure becomes Newton per meter square. Now we have to find expression for pressure inside a liquid. Expression for pressure inside a liquid. So you people can see here that I have taken a container in which I have a liquid filled. I have to find pressure at point P. I have to find pressure at point P, which is at the height of H, which is at the height of H from the surface, from the liquid surface. So what are the points to be taken into assumption? The first point is mass of the liquid is M. Mass of the liquid is M. Density of the liquid is rho. That symbol what you see here, it is rho. Then point at which pressure is to be measured is point P. Height of the point P inside liquid is H. The height can be seen, it is H units. Now a generalization, what happens when we go inside a liquid? What happens to the pressure? Okay, our general experience while we swimming, you can see that the pressure increases as we go down and down. We have also seen into submarines. What happens if the submarines go down and down in the sea? The pressure on the submarine increases. Why is that? Because the pressure at any point inside a liquid is due to weight of the liquid. It is due to weight of the liquid. So we'll see here what is thrust at a point. What is thrust at a point? So thrust at a point is mass of liquid into gravity, acceleration due to gravity, which is nothing but weight of the liquid, mass of liquid into gravity. So what it is, thrust is M into G. Mass of the liquid is M, acceleration due to gravity is G. We know that density rho is equal to mass divided by volume. So how do we calculate mass? If we take volume to the other side, it becomes rho into V. So mass we substitute as rho into V, then we have thrust is equal to rho Vg. Now we know what is volume. Volume is area into height. Volume is area into height. I substitute that. Therefore, my thrust becomes rho into A into H into G. Now, I am to find what is pressure at point P. So, pressure at point P is thrust divided by area. Thrust divided by area. So, cross-sectional area around P is taken as A. So, which gives me the equation. Thrust is rho A H G divided by area is A. Therefore, A and A cancels from numerator and denominator. Finally, we get the equation for pressure as rho into H into G. Therefore, you can see here, acceleration due to gravity G is constant. Rho is density. So, as the density of the liquid increases, pressure inside that liquid also increases. If the height in the liquid increases, then what happens? Pressure also increases. That's the reason when we go down and down, when we go to higher depths, what happens? Pressure inside a liquid increases. Now, we have cohesive force and adhesive force. Okay, taking the example, the concept of cohesive forces and adhesive forces, we'll be studying what is surface tension. So, what is cohesive force? The force of attraction between molecules of the same substance is called cohesive force. The force of attraction between molecules of same substance. Say, same substance, we take it as two molecules of iron. Iron is one substance, and force between two molecules of iron is what? Cohesive force. It is the force of attraction between one iron molecule and another iron molecule. So, the substances are same. Therefore, we call it as cohesive force. If you are taking force of attraction between two water molecules, which is the force of attraction between same substance, because water molecules is same thing. Therefore, that force is also called as cohesive force, the force of attraction between same substance. Now, we have adhesive forces. So, what is adhesive force? The force of attraction between the molecules of different substance is called adhesive force. The force of attraction between different substances. So, I have to take one molecule of one substance, another molecule of another substance, and what is the force of attraction between them? That I name it as adhesive force. So, that example is given by force between water molecules on glass. Okay, so we have seen many times when we pour water on the glass, the water slides away. The water slides away. So, what is that force between water molecules and glass? That is adhesive force. When we write on the board using a chalk, so what is the force between chalk piece and board? That is also a adhesive force, because chalk piece is one molecule, one substance, and board material is another substance. So, it is force of attraction between different substances. Here also, if you can see, water molecule is one substance and glass is another substance. The force of attraction between them is adhesive force. Now, taking the concept of cohesive force, we'll be studying what is surface tension. So, first I'll give the definition, then I'll explain what is surface tension. It is the property of the liquid due to which the liquid drop behaves like a stretched elastic membrane and tries to occupy minimum surface area. So, consider a liquid molecule. We have a liquid molecule. Inside this liquid molecule, we have again liquid atoms. On the surface as well as liquid molecules on the inside. So, what happens? We know what is cohesive force. The cohesive force is force of attraction between molecules of same substance. So, what happens? This water molecule attracts this molecule towards inside. This water molecule attracts this molecule towards inside. So, all the molecules are attracted towards inside. So, what happens? As a result, all the molecules on the surface are getting closely attracted towards center. And what happens? Finally, the liquid drop acquires minimum surface area. The surface area, what we can see here, this becomes minimum due to surface tension. Now we'll be studying what are the factors affecting surface tension. So temperature is one of the factors which affects surface tension. Surface tension of a liquid depends on temperature. How? As the temperature increases, the surface tension of a liquid decreases. What happens? As the temperature increases, the surface tension decreases. And then impurities or contamination. If there is presence of impurities, how the surface tension is affected? As the impurities in the liquid increase, the surface tension decreases. Therefore, if we are adding oil into the water, what happens? We are adding impurity. Oil here will be impurity. If we are adding dust particles to water, what happens? Dust particles become impurity and they reduce the surface tension of the water. If you are adding inside oil, if you are adding kerosene, so what happens? Kerosene here will be impurity. Therefore, it decreases surface tension of oil. So what are the applications of surface tension? So we all have seen, where do the mosquitoes lay their eggs? They lay it on wastewater. They lay their eggs on wastewater. So they do not drown. They don't go inside water, the mosquito eggs. They are very light in weight, but they are supported on the surface of the water due to high surface tension of water. So how it is prevented? What happens? Sometimes oil is sprayed on the water surfaces where there are mosquito eggs laid. So what happens when oil is sprayed? What happens? Surface tension decreases. Therefore, mosquito eggs, they go inside the water. Okay. So here we have first application. Then what happens? While washing our clothes, we use detergents. Yes, we all know we use detergents. So what do the detergents do? So in clean water, we are adding detergent as impurity, contamination. So what happens? They also lower the surface tension of water and hence the water can flow through the pores of the cloth and clothes get cleaned easily. Again, while we have some wounds, we use antiseptics like Dettol, many other things. So what happens? Antiseptics like Dettol have low surface tension and due to low surface tension, they spread very easily on the wound and they cover maximum area and they clean the surface. Okay, so these are the applications of surface tension. There are few more properties of liquids which I'll be studying in further lectures. Thank you.